So I was playing a match the other day, and you know, the serve wasn't going at all. I was trying to serve, I was putting so much effort, but the serve was going so slow. I couldn't place it. I was even starting to have some kind of pain on my shoulder, and I couldn't figure out what was I doing wrong to improve it. So I couldn't do it, and I ended up losing the match. I got broken so many times. And after the match, what I decided to do is, I told a friend, I gave him my phone, and I told him to record myself. I wanted to know by myself, what could I do to improve it, you know? So we do that all the time with our students, you know, we take our phone, we take a camera, we record them, we analyze them. But last time that I recorded myself, it was like a few years back, and I couldn't really understand what was I doing wrong, that I was losing all that power. So I recorded myself, and what I found out is that I was doing one of the most common mistakes that so many beginner players do when they do the surf. Was I pronated? Yeah, I was pronated. I was reaching up. I was turning my body. I was doing so many things right, but one of the basic things that so many people do, I wasn't doing it, and that's what I was missing on my surf. So what was I doing wrong? After I got into my trophy position, until that point I was doing it perfectly. Once I got to this position, before I started reaching up and dropping my racket backwards, what I was doing is I was bringing my elbow next to my body and dropping it so close. So I was lacking so much power by bringing my elbow here next to my body and then from here reaching up. And that's something I really couldn't figure out myself. Even after that, I tried to do a few serves and I couldn't really feel like I was bringing it. So what did I do? After I saw myself doing it, I found out a few drills, a few exercises that could help me doing this improvement of my serve, and I recorded myself a couple days later. That's when I recorded today. So the only thing that I had to do to improve on that is make the serve simple, okay? I divided the serve on different parts, so it's where I could focus on keeping my elbow up on the different parts on the movement, and that's what helped me improve my serve. You will see the serve that I end up doing today. You will see that the difference in power on that serve is huge. I went from a maybe like a 80, 90 miles per hour average serve to this last one that I served, it was probably somewhere around 115, 120 miles per hour. So basically what I did is, the first drill that I did, I started doing the surf with my arm up. So instead of doing the whole motion and doing everything so complex, what I did is I brought my arm up here, even with the head of the racket down, I tossed the ball, and from here, I only went up. So I didn't have, since I wasn't doing this first backswing, I wasn't able to drop my elbow and I was able to focus only on this part of the motion. So after I did a few reps of that, I was able to control this part of the movement, so I went to the next part. What was the next part? I was starting the motion with the trophy position. That was the position where I was having trouble, because after this one, that's when I was bringing my elbow down. So I thought that I was gonna have problems with that one. So again, I told a friend to record myself doing that. The few reps, I was bringing my elbow a little bit closer, but it was getting better. And after I did somewhere between 20 and 30 reps of this exercise, I was able to keep my elbow up here and go up. So after I got that one, what I did, I started doing a few shadow swings of my full motion. So I started doing some shadow swings, getting my elbow here and then going up. I did a few of them. Then after I got the shadow swings, after my muscles were starting to get the whole motion, I added one ball after a shadow swing. So I could do a full shadow swing with my serve, with my elbow up, and after that I could get a ball, and I could do the full serve with the ball. After that again, another shadow swing, then another ball. Shadow swing, ball all the time. So I could keep switching until I could feel comfortable while doing the serve, and that's when I started just doing the full serve. And the difference that I felt on my last serves, it was huge. I was starting to get way more power, and I was also trying to feel way more comfortable and consistent with the motion. And that's something that I also added to my kick serve. It's not like I only did it on the first serve. I also added to my kick serve, and that allowed me to get way more racket speed and get way more spin on that ball. So that's something I should definitely suggest you to try to do it if you have this problem. And even if you don't have it, it's always good to have those drills to try to improve yourself in certain areas. So now I'm gonna let you see the last reps that I did of the serve, and you will be able to see a difference. If you like our content, make sure you like our video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, don't forget to check on the description. We have a few links that they might be interested for you. So I will see you in the next video.